recently celebrated International Women's Day this year on 8th of March. This day now has a long tradition of being recognized as the Women's Day since the early 1900s. But again this year, the debate concerning who actually must be classified in the category of being a woman. But here's the thing. The fact that somebody does not classify trans woman as woman reinforces the dangerous idea that there is a particular way of being a woman. This is Shubhika Singh and you're watching CUTV. In this episode, we aim to discuss the growing transphobia on online platforms and what can we do to make it a better, secure place for the LGBTQIA+ community.
I'm Emma, and in this CUTV News episode, we're exploring transgenderism, pronouns, and social media. Social media has become the new public sphere where opinions are formed through activist groups as well as through destructive hate groups. Many of you may have also noticed that a new trend has started. Cisgender people are putting their pronouns on social media too, usually in support of the transgender and queer community. This is an example from an Instagram bio. I'm interviewing two Jamies today, Jamie Ellis and Jamie Tsize, a transgender woman and a transgender man, for their opinions. Hi Jamie and Jamie, thank you for joining me today. For the audience, how would you like to be addressed?
I go by she and her pronouns.
Thank you for having me, first of all. And my pronouns are he, him, Jamie's fine. Anything nice is fine.
Do you both of you find yourselves correcting people with your pronouns?
I do from time to time, but I find that the people I correct aren't doing it because they disagree with my decisions. It's just because they have known me for so long as he and him.
So yeah, at the moment, probably because I've not yet gone on hormone replacement therapy.
As for the topic of social media and pronouns, what is your opinion on cisgender people defining their gender in their descriptions and bios?
From my point of view, I don't really understand their reasons for doing it. Because with trans people, for example, it's their way of expressing what they identify as and how they want people to refer them to. Whereas with a cisgendered individual, they sort of don't really need that.
I like it because of two reasons. You know, if you're a trans person and you put your pronouns in your bio, I feel like it's a bit of a tell that you're trans. But if everybody started doing it, then you would pass better. That's one. And then second of all, it makes me kind of relieved because then you'll never insult anyone. And also, you know that person kind of supports the trans community.
Have either of you had any negative experiences on social media?
A couple. There's a few, you know, university kind of like anonymous post Facebook pages that sometimes just spew far-right people that, you know, are like trans women aren't women, and that just gets my blood boiling. Negative things happen to me on the internet is when I comment on like posts and things.
My experiences have been okay, actually. I've been quite fortunate. The amount of support I've had from people has been incredible, or even just strangers online who see my work.
As for the wider transgender and queer community, what do you think are some of the key issues that they face online?
Because of the fact that so many trans people feel the need to over-sexualize themselves and over-feminize themselves, it sort of gives uneducated people that sort of stereotism of trans people.
Would you say then that they fetishize the transgender and queer community?
Immensely, yeah. If you are a trans individual and someone asks you if you're trans, more often than not, they will ask very sexualized questions, as it were. Have you had the op? How many people have you slept with, kind of thing? Have you considered being an escort?
Jamie Tsize, what do you think?
People being very dismissive and they don't make it like a conscious effort. It does affect you when you like hear the news and you're like, oh, another four trans women have been murdered. You know, people being mean to Elliot Page. The hardest bit is just reading what a high proportion of the world is just against your entire existence.
To add to that, what are your opinions on the rise of transphobic hate groups such as the Super Straights?
Yes, there are people out there who don't necessarily find dating or being with a trans person attractive. That's absolutely fine, that's their decision. But the fact that there are people out there who feel the need to express their dislike for people making those decisions when it doesn't concern them, I find it very nonsensical.
I kind of hate that they've been given a platform, to be honest, because it did all start from a TikTok video, and you know, it's a ridiculous notion. So you should have just left it where it was. I know for a fact a lot of trans people already think that they're unlovable and they don't deserve love, or they won't find anybody they love. You don't need a whole identity to rub it in trans people's faces that they're not as much of that gender as you are. You know, you can just, you know, just leave it be. Just be a nice person.
Jamie Cisse added another interesting point. He doesn't understand why transgenderism or gender is really debated or talked about as much as it is today. A BBC publication described that Western colonialization has made transgenderism less socially acceptable today. The history of gender fluidity may be being destroyed by colonialist norms. In native Indian communities, they have four genders and view gender fluid individuals as sacred two-spirit beings. In India, there is a third gender, or the sacred gender, and have scriptures depicting 20 to even 28 genders. Aboriginal Australians have historically as well accepted what they call brother boys and sister girls.
Of course, individuals have the right to free speech and to voice their opinions. The process of cancel culture is potentially counterproductive in derailing discourse around what are pertinent issues. However, individuals such as J.K. Rowling and Ricky Gervais using their presence on social media to single out and criticise or question non-cisgendered people is potentially damaging to the cause of creating safe spaces for them on social media platforms and online in general.